I am so happy that you're able to join us for this extended interview. Make sure to visit theoffbeatlife.com. Again, that's theoffbeatlife.com to get more killer resources. Hey everyone, thank you so much for joining us for this extended interview with Jomi. Hey Jomi.
Hey Debbie.
Thanks for being here again. Can you tell us a little bit more about you and why you live an offbeat life?
Right. So I used to have a six-figure e-commerce company in the Philippines, and then I closed this to start traveling and start another company, this time consulting with other business owners to create businesses that they love on autopilot.
One of your big things is building a business from your vision. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
I'm such a fan of starting with a why. So if you've heard of Simon Sinek before, or if not, you should Google him, Simon Sinek. He has this best-selling book called Start With A Why. And you can use this for your business primarily, where you use your unique mission, your unique purpose in this world, and bake that into your brand. And then from there, build everything you need. Your business strategy, your marketing strategy, your team, your manifesto, everything. And you're going to have a company that grows faster and more organically.
Now, how can someone get the clarity to find their own vision and mission?
There are a couple exercises that you can do. And it's nothing technical or nothing hard, and anyone can do this. And it's what really helped me get clear on what it is that I wanted to do, the bigger thing that I wanted to do in life. So the first one is actually not my technique, it's someone else's. I forgot who exactly did it, but this is a little variation of that. Basically, go into some quiet place, a couple deep breaths, like 10 deep breaths. And once you're in that space where you're not thinking of anything else, and you know nothing's there to distract you, like, just ask yourself, what is your idea of the perfect world? What does utopia look like for you? Like, if you could create the perfect world right now in front of you, what would that look like? What would your life look like? What would the life of strangers around you look like? And if you can answer that question, then that's your vision. That's the vision of the world that only you can see and that no one else can. That's your own personal mission. So that's how you get clear on why it is you're here and what it is you're supposed to do. Now, how to incorporate that into your business requires a bit more steps. But honestly, if you get clear on that, just that first step, like, and it may sound very simple, but you may have to do it like a couple more times until you can verbalize it. Because for me, for example, for the longest time, like, I could see it, but I couldn't say it. It's through doing it a couple times, going through that exercise, and maybe doing some automatic writing on it. Like, ask yourself, like, What is my vision? What is a perfect world for me? Or what is heaven and earth for some other people? That question works better. What's your idea of heaven and earth? And then just write, and then get really clear on that. And then it's just going to hit home, and that's going to be your vision. Then from there, move on to, like, who is the person, this perfect person, this ideal client that you can help? Like, what is his problem? Like, what is he feeling? What is he feeling right now? Is he alone, scared, afraid? You know, what is he feeling? What is he thinking? What are the thoughts going through his head right now? And what is he doing? What are the things that he's doing before you appear in his life to help him? So that way you get clear about why it is you're here, who it is you want to do it for. And from there, it'll be just a few more steps into, like, building the perfect business for you that, you know, that resonates with your soul on a deeper level.
And that's really hard to do, because a lot of us don't usually listen to ourselves, because there's so many things that's distracting you from your actual vision. There's so many people giving you their ideas and their input that you forget to listen to your own. So having that clarity and just listening to yourself is so crucial to that.
A lot of people, like, they for this exercise, that's why I'm saying, like, go to a quiet place and then, like, take 10 deep breaths and try to quiet your mind. Because honestly, the answer is not going to come from your conscious mind, you know, because your logical mind is going to say, oh, I have to do this because, you know, like, so-and-so makes this money, made money from this before. So, like, this is my vision. Like, so you have all this logical part of your brain, like, telling you what it is. And you have to quiet down that part of your brain so you can let your soul speak.
Now, we touched up a little bit on this for the initial interview that we have, and you mentioned that you wish people asked you more about how you can actually build a business that you love. How do we do that, Jomi?
The one thing that has helped me is to not make decisions that don't feel good. Like, learning to trust every entrepreneur will understand this, I think, like learning to trust your gut more. Early on in the beginning of of my entrepreneurial journey, I would make a lot of like logical decisions and then just base it purely on logic. And then over time, as you become more seasoned as an entrepreneur, you learn that a lot of your best decisions aren't the ones that they're based on numbers you look at stats, you look at reports, of course, but they're only there to confirm what it is your gut already knows. There was even an interview with Jeff Bezos, you can Google it, where he says what the best decisions that he made in his life, in his career, were the ones he made based on his gut. And even like Richard Branson, he makes business decisions about a person within 10 seconds of shaking his hand. Mm. So yeah, so it's developing that entrepreneurial gut instinct that will really help you build a business that you love. So yeah.
There's so much that your inner self can tell you without even having to do anything. You have those instincts and those gut feelings, and you shouldn't ignore them because sometimes they know more than what your brain will be able to tell you and what other people can tell you. You really have to trust yourself.
At the end of the day, you are responsible for your actions. You're responsible for your life. You're responsible for your happiness. And you have to listen to that part of you all the time, no matter what.
That is so true. Well, thank you so much, Jomi, for speaking with us today. I really appreciate it.
Yes, I'm so happy to be here. I'm so glad I met you online. You're like, you have a really great show here and you have a great website. Keep on doing what you're doing.
Thank you, Jomi. You too. Now, if our listeners want to know more about you, where can they find you?
Yes, find me on Facebook. Just search Jomi Casas. Add me.
Awesome. Thank you. And we will definitely follow your journey. Hopefully you get that sailboat that you talked about in our previous interview.
I'll let you know when it happens.
I hope you enjoyed this extended interview with Jomi. Make sure to visit theoffbeatlife.com. Again, that's theoffbeatlife.com to get the full interview with Jomi, where she shares how to build a passive six-figure business through automation. Hey, Offbeat family, I really appreciate you listening to this episode. I would love to hear more from you and what you think of the podcast. Suggestions on guests, topics we can discuss, or maybe you just want to be friends. Why don't we chat some more on Facebook at The OB Life or send me a message at hello@theoffbeatlife.com. I can't wait to hear from you.